McCain proves he is a traitor, refuses to answer one important question. Whatever Mr. McCain may have once thought about loyalty should just be ancient history. With regards to fights in the Senate, he can't be relied upon. Or, on the other hand, rather, he can be relied upon to cut the president and conservatives in the back. It remains a flat-out catastrophe that this man is reliably named by the Republicans of Arizona as their contender for U.S. Senate. Now and again it appears just as McCain's unfaithfulness and unfairness know no limits. It's one thing to haughtily depict yourself as a maverick while voting to sink Republican legislation and discourage the Republican president. It's very another to purposely unite with the Restriction Party in a demonstration of political injustice. However, doubtlessly this portrays McCain and his activities consummately. The defamed Trump dossier stays in the news. We're not astounded to discover that Hillary and the DNC paid for its creation. It's completely disgusting that McCain is the person who delivered the phony archive to the FBI. This was no respectable demonstration of simply giving proof to specialists. This is a piece of McCain proceeding with endeavors to crush the Trump administration. Exhibiting the quitter that he is, he now declines to answer inquiries in any capacity associated with this dossier. In December, it was McCain who notoriously passed the controversial dossier produced by the Washington firm Fusion GPS to then-FBI Director James Comey, whose agency reportedly utilized the dossier as a partial basis for its probe into alleged Russian interference in the 2016 presidential election. McCain's office did not respond to repeated Breitbart News phone and email requests over the course of last week and this week seeking comment on whether the Arizona senator was aware that the material he passed to the FBI was paid for by the DNC and Clinton's campaign. McCain's office also did not respond to requests for information on how he first obtained the dossier, which is filled with discredited charges. The way that this man remains administrator of anything in the Senate is an arraignment of gutless Republican Senate leaders. Outfitted with a noteworthy chance to move the country in a conservative course, they are wasting that with useless leaders, for example, Mitch McConnell and deceivers, for example, John McCain. Earlier this month, McCain denied providing the dossier to BuzzFeed and said that he only gave the material to the FBI. I gave it to no one except for the director of the FBI. I don't know why you're digging this up now, McCain told the Daily Caller during what the news website described as a testy exchange. It is not immediately clear how McCain obtained the dossier in the first place. A January 11 statement from McCain attempted to explain why he provided the documents to the FBI but did not mention how he came to possess the dossier or whether he knew WHO-funded IT. May we recommend that Mr. McCain is lying? He, in any event, isn't being useful or inevitable in regards to his contribution with this dossier. It's very conceivable, even likely, that this man was clandestinely supporting Hillary's campaign. We unquestionably realize that he had and has no utilization for Donald Trump. Would it be able to be desirously finished the way that Trump won? Would McCain neglected to accomplish that produces such enmity? Provided that this is true, John McCain is a little and extremely malignant man. We've had all that anyone could need of John McCain. Would you be able to envision what might happen? Would he say he was a Democrat and were pulling these tricks against President Obama or Hillary? As appalling, however, as that is, to think of it as could possibly not hope to compare to what Democratic authority may do to rectify Mr. McCain's terrible disposition. It is past time for action. Consequently, of his bad form and disloyalty, Mr. McCain must be stripped of his panel chairmanship. Further, he ought to be expelled from any board that touches remote undertakings or our furnished administrations. Put him on the committees that oversee road maintenance in D.C. His opportunity as U.S. representative should meet the disgraceful end it so luxuriously merits. What do you think about this? Do not hesitate and write your thoughts in the comment section below.